you?
We are doing great. C4, let me just take a few minutes listeners, because it is a little weird when you drive around and hear you guys talking about us. So,
like a third person.
Exactly,
right?
Like a third person, you know. Anyway, let me just say this. First of all, obviously, congratulations go out to Governor O'Malley, Lieutenant Governor Brown, and their families. And I think that Marylanders recognize that we gave it one last shot, and the numbers weren't close. It is closure here in Maryland, unfortunately, maybe for a long time for the Republican Party, certainly for the Ehrlichs. My husband is doing fine. I think he's feeling, why did I even try? And I think most of the listeners and many people that have stopped us, talked to us, thank him for trying one more time to give it one more shot. C4, we have talked many times about the numbers in the state and the demographic, and it's just too difficult. It is too much of a Democratic state. Bob has always argued it's the most Democratic state. Like we mentioned about Massachusetts, a lot more independents there. It's incredibly difficult, and this just showed it. It had changed a lot since 2002 when he was able to thread that needle. I will, a little inside baseball here, and that is, back in the decision time of the winter, Bob's pollster, who has been with him a long time, said, we're seeing this tide. If there is another time that you might be able to do it, this would be it. It's certainly not in four more years. Bob knew a lot of the demographics that you and I have discussed, C4. So at any rate, he decided to go forward. And what is just interesting is that tide never really reached Maryland. And then in hindsight, of course, we don't want to do too much Monday morning quarterbacking because we don't need to. It was, too big a win. And so we don't need to say, one more ad this way, that way, this many more dollars. It really wouldn't have occurred
Plus, Peter and I have done it already. So.
Yeah, okay. So the good news for me is I haven't listened to a thing or read a thing all week. But anyway.
The tide did lap on the shore for Andy Harris. That was about it.
A little bit. I think, the shore generally goes that way anyway. That district has always generally been a Republican. I think more so that the tide didn't go that way last time. But at any rate, I will say that the tide for four states that stayed very Democratic, the facts are that President Obama's approval rating in those four states, which I'm going to give you in a minute, was 50% or above. And then it was just going to be too hard to crack. The wave of 2006, there was a very low approval of the president at that time. And particularly in Maryland, I think that probably has effect. If President Obama's approval was much lower,
right,
then that may have made things at least closer or, been able to thread the needle. But those states are California, New York, Massachusetts, and Maryland, the most Democratic and the most liberal-leaning states in the country. So there you have it, folks. And, the Ehrlichs have the flag. We're about to close out the lights, turn out the lights. And it's just a shame because the party is going to be hurting for a long time. I wish that weren't the case, but it's going to be very difficult for the party to raise money. And with redistricting coming and probably the demographics getting even stronger, more Democratic, it's going to be a long time. We have to savor. We really should put in a big bow and savor that great 4 years. My husband did a great job. It was very classy. It was just wonderful. We should savor that and keep all those memories in the box on the show.